to Martin the Machines, and I'm sort of proud to announce the first airing of Tank Brush Commander, a series documenting that I actually can paint. Today I will document how I start with painting all my remaining War Machine models, and they are numerous. Not outrageously numerous, but most of Kardos infantry and jacks. You have seen them on the reports, Silver Fishes and Black Jacks, and now I will show you how I put them into Technicolor. Enjoy. Alright, this is our stash for the first wave. Since I'm one of those that have the ability to paint a number of similar models to a similar degree without suffering from brain meltdown, but downright fail at details, all of the jacks will be first. Their painting process is similar enough so it doesn't require rethinking or a change in colors. Yes, I'm more of a quantity painter. Okay, here's step 0. Disassemble the jacks again, remove the glue and gather the parts for priming. Step 1, prime time and dark patching. Two side notes. I always prime black. I can't get how people can prime white, but I guess that's just me. Second, the Widowmakers and Great Bears were there because I was dark patching anyways. This is how I call painting the spots black which, by hand, which didn't get enough primer from the spray. And they needed it. Step 2. I applied the very basic color, Catechin Green. It covers all the areas which will be a lighter green later on. Side note, we habitually use GW's paint range. Step 3 and 4. I applied the second and third basic colors, Bastard Brown for all things golden and Shadow Grey for the red areas. Yeah, you heard that right. You don't think this works? Well then stay tuned for a surprise. Next step, I've signaled the Devastator to be finished first. Once I get to work on the metal parts and lighter layers, I stick to one jack so I don't forget to paint any important parts. I'll finish the legs first, because that part is then finished and done, and I can pre-assemble the model again to check which parts aren't that visible, and those parts get a little less attention. Why paint something you won't see in play anyway? I took care of the steel areas in 3 takes. First, bolt gun metal, then wash liberally with better black, then bolt gun metal highlighting. Chainmail is already too bright. Next up was finishing the green. To do so, I put on a layer of straight Nalak green, which suits my taste for a military olive drab. Then wash it with Thraka green. Then another layer of Nalak green, but this time I watched not to paint over the darker areas again. Following this, the gold. 50 brazen brass shining gold, followed by the one wash Devlin mud, highlighted by shining gold. Last step, fix any mispaintings. These do happen since I paint everything with a size O brush. Following the legs, I did the head and I prefitted the arms, shoulder and top carapace to check what else could be seen inside and then went to paint it in the same steps as described above. I then did the shoulder pads the same way. Actually, starting with this jack, I will steer away from a rather glossy original painting style to a more sophisticated application of washes to enhance a 3D look. At least, at the very least, I got this Devastator finished, and I hope that you get to see him, Nikita, in an upcoming battle report. So until then, farewell.